Omaha's news leader, chronicling the stories and people making a difference in our community. This is KETV News Watch 7's Chronicle.
We are here to help support the Texas National Guard, you know, just helping try to monitor as many areas as possible to help.
Oh, we KETV News Watch 7 has brought you exclusive coverage from the U.S.-Mexico border.
We're kind of there to observe, direct, and report.
The Nebraska National Guard deployed for weeks as part of Operation Lone Star.
Extraordinarily sobering, the humanitarian crisis.
Governor Jim Pillen calls the troops a protection for kids in Nebraska.
We're helping our neighbor Texas, and we're helping ourselves to protect our kids.
But what are our Guard members doing day to day there, and how is it helping?
I mean, nothing's ever going to be perfect, but I would say with the help and all the other states that have came out here, I would say it's been very successful.
Good morning and welcome to KETV News Watch 7's Chronicle. We're reporting from Eagle Pass, Texas, a place the Nebraska National Guard has called home for the last 8 weeks. It's the second straight year they've been deployed to help secure our southern border. But what does that mean? How have things changed since we saw thousands of migrants a day trying to cross this past December? And is Nebraska's presence making a difference? These are all questions we came down here to answer. For the next 30 minutes, we'll skip the politics of the border crisis and introduce you to the Nebraskans working to keep our border safe and to the people of Eagle Pass who've been through it all. First, the data. Migrant crossings peaked in December 2023 at more than 300,000, and nowhere was that more evident than in Eagle Pass. Since then, they've fallen by about a third. Shelby Park in Eagle Pass is a public space right along the border that's been taken over by a military presence. And it's a place that saw thousands of migrants coming per day just a few months ago. That's where we start. The National Guard has escorted us inside Shelby Park. This is the Rio Grande River right here. It didn't take long for us to find, just beyond the wire and the fencing, a family trying to get into the United States. You can see it looks like they have a young child with them.
It's a sight they're used to seeing here in Shelby Park. Like so many others, this family will now be detained and, depending on charges, sent immediately back to Mexico or given a court date and released in the U.S. The Rio Grande River stretches more than 1,200 miles along the Mexico-Texas border. The Nebraska National Guard is helping to observe less than 1% of that.
So Nebraska operates out of static points. We have a Humvee stationed at each of these high traffic areas. And there will be a Nebraska personnel and a Texas personnel working together.
They're stationed about 20 miles north of Eagle Pass in Komodo, but two of their leaders met us at Shelby Park to talk about their mission.
So really, we're kind of there to observe, direct, and report.
They work 8-hour shifts, usually 5 days a week. A Nebraska crew is on the clock and helping 24/7.
Families are coming across using clothes and whatever means available to get across the wire that we have set in place, and then walking up to us and essentially giving themselves up.
They call their role strictly observational.
Nebraska is allowed to tell them to basically sit, stay where they are, put their hands behind their back, but we don't have any arresting authority. We just hand them over to the local law enforcement.
Like almost every other Nebraska Guard member, they have civilian jobs. First Lieutenant Jonathan Engelman works in construction back in Lincoln.
Some people want to get away from their civilian jobs for a little while. Some people, you know, want to do Army stuff. Some people just like the camaraderie.
Master Sergeant Andrew Cookston works with veterans across the state. He lives in Milford with his wife and kids.
Miss you, love you. Hi.
In December 2023, Shelby Park looked like this. It was a holding area for days when as many as 4,500 illegal migrants would cross. Officials say it's a perfect spot because of low water levels. And it's the reason nearly three dozen Nebraskans immediately volunteered to help.
You know, it's something we wanted to do. So we volunteered. It's just something bigger than ourselves.
Obviously, things look a lot different in Shelby Park. I've asked locals why that is, and they say it's a variety of factors, and an expanded military presence is one of them. As we mentioned, Nebraska's expanded presence is actually north of Eagle Pass, outside a small town called Komodo. We're here at an observation point known as Two Tubes. Mexico is about 200 yards that way, past the brush in the Rio Grande. It's one of 5 points a Nebraska crew has been manning 24/7. Their mission, to prevent, deter, and interdict. Boots on the ground for more than 50 days.
You get more of the general area, you can see more down here.
Sergeant Colin Quick paused his job in Omaha.
I'm a diesel mechanic. Yeah, I just work in a lot of semis, you know.
To help watch the border as part of Operation Lone Star. To cross into the U.S., at this point, someone would have to get across the river and then through this thick brush. Quick says he hasn't seen anyone try to do it.
Right now, it's just a listening and observing part, but if you see somebody out there by the fence or messing with the fence, you'll call DPS and they'll come out here and take care of the situation as best they can.
He and nearly three dozen other National Guard airmen and soldiers are keeping watch over a 5-mile stretch near Kamado, about 20 miles north of Eagle Pass. On Wednesday, Staff Sergeant Jason Everly was security at this gate just north of town.
We're monitoring points of possible entry for individuals coming across the border.
Crews work 8-hour shifts, rotating tactical points.
We are here to help support the Texas National Guard, just helping try to monitor as many areas as possible to help.
Each is paired with a member of the Texas National Guard.
You get to learn your counterparts, you know. It helps build relationships and camaraderie.
Watching, listening, and waiting.
I mean, nothing's ever going to be perfect, but I would say with the help and all the other states that have came out here, I would say it's been very successful.
The Nebraska National Guard has about 5 full weeks left on their mission. And whether they see people trying to cross the border or not, they consider their presence a deterrence and therefore their mission a success.
We're here in Kamado, the focal point of the Nebraska National Guard's mission. Now, just about roughly 40 miles north, that is where camp is. And that's where the Guard spends the majority of their time when they're off duty. It's also where they start their days in a routine that's not much different than what they would be doing back home in Nebraska.
You wake up, you come out here, you do your job, and then you go home, you go eat, you know, just like a regular job back home, you could say.
Sergeant Colin Quick is a diesel mechanic back home in Omaha repairing semi-trucks. But here in Texas, he helps man different points along the border in Kamado, along with other Nebraska National Guard soldiers.
We work 4 on, 2 off, you know, and that's about it.
Monitoring each individual points. We have a roving point that goes back and forth as well, making sure all the soldiers and everybody are taken care of, staying hydrated, just checking on their well-being, make sure they're not going a little stir crazy at times, being out here every day for long periods of time.
Working the border can be hot and stressful, and just like any other job, sometimes you need to de-stress.
They got, you know, little yard games that we can play and nice places just to sit around and converse and have like actual interactions without having to worry about the stress of work.
We asked to see their living quarters, but for security reasons, we weren't allowed. As for their weekends back at camp, even in Texas, they're pretty normal.
Whatever time you wake up, usually 8 for me. I don't like sleeping in. But then you go to the gym, you know, make the day go by, watch some movies, you know, do the most you can.
Doing a walk around the base to get the cardio in and just kind of hanging out, lounging around.
For Staff Sergeant Jason Everly, that also includes calls back home to his wife and 5 kids.
Miss the family back home.
What's the first thing you're going to do when you get back to Lincoln?
Hug my family. And then go camping.
The countdown for the Nebraska National Guard making their way back home is underway. Just about 5 weeks.
I'm trying not to because I know it'll make it feel longer, but I am deep down keep counting, you know.
Now, something that we've heard from all the Nebraska National Guardsmen about being here in Texas is the heat. It's been triple digits every single day we have been here. That's why you will find at every single station a cooler filled to the brim with waters as the Guardsmen, they try to keep cool in weather that they're not used to back home in Nebraska. Reporting from the border, Eddie Messel, KETV, Newswatch 7.
And in coordinating this trip, we went through the Nebraska National Guard and the Texas Military Department. We're incredibly grateful for the men and women who helped make it happen. Here's more on the 4 Nebraska National Guardsmen who took time out of their shifts to show us around and answer our questions, both serious and lighthearted.
I grew up in Blair, Nebraska, but recently moved to Omaha. I'm a diesel mechanic. Yeah, I just work in a lot of semis, you know. I'm excited to get back to the river. It's not much of a restaurant, but Cottonwood Cove. You know, you gotta shout them out sometimes, but That's it right there.
I'm Staff Sergeant in the Air Force. Name is Jason.
A little more than halfway through a 90-day deployment, right?
Yes, sir.
How's it been so far?
Hot. A little humid. A little more humid than back home, so. I'm from Lincoln. I work full-time for the Air National Guard as a federal technician out of the airbase. Family. Okay. Miss the family back home. Wife and five kids. I call them every night. Yep, able to video call them.
What's the first thing you're gonna do when you get back to Lincoln?
Hug my family. And then go camping.
I'm First Lieutenant Engelman, and I'm the OIC, or the officer in charge, for this mission. A lot of our guys, we get together at night and play cornhole, so we have some fun with that. They got, yeah, all sorts of stuff to do, really. Down here, I've enjoyed working with the Texas National Guard and all our law enforcement partners. They are actually really good to work with. They've treated us very well down here. Southern hospitality is a real thing, so.
Okay, so I am Master Sergeant Cookston, Andrew Cookston. I'm the NCOIC of Operation Lone Star. It's always fun. I mean, the camaraderie is great. We're Air Force, so we get made fun of a lot, but that's a good thing. We give it right back because we're a little smarter. We let them know that usually.
What's the hardest part about everything?
Probably being away from home. I mean, you know, a lot of us have families, and if we don't have families, we have friends, and if we don't have friends, we have dogs. You know, everybody has something back in Nebraska, but that's why we're here, just to help Texas make a difference, and then everybody get home safely. Yeah, as my wife and kids, right? I got two boys and a wife, of course. So I miss them dearly, but I'll see them soon enough. Miss you, love you. Hi.
After the break, we're talking to the people of Eagle Pass and the first responders who've seen it all. The tragedies and near tragedies they've seen while trying to keep people safe, whether they're American or illegally trying to get into the U.S.